So I have a question. Why do people with dark skin scar differently than people with light skin? I know what you're thinking. This is probably one of the most random questions that you'd start thinking to yourself, but every question has a reason behind it. I was in the shower, having a shower, as you do, and I looked down on my right leg and noticed the scars that I've had for a couple of years.
Right, so these are my surgery scars. As you can see, there's all four in a line. There's four because when they do the surgery, they do two at a time. So my first surgery were these two, and that's where they went in. And much to my surprise, I thought they were gonna go in again through these two for my second surgery, and I woke up to find these two. This one is a lot more prominent than the other three, because this one got infected, which was excellent, and I had to take antibiotics for it. People usually assume that I've got tattoos here rather than them being scars. And you know, for me, the experience has been kind of difficult. I think with the process of scars, it takes some time to accept this change. At the same time though, the scar is in a place where it's not seen all of the time. Although it's bothersome, and in an ideal world, we should all be able to kind of accept our scars and accept our differences and be able to thrive regardless, there is still this stigma that comes around with scarring. So the fact that mine are not always visible has been easier for me to process, as it would be, I guess, if they were somewhere that was seen all of the time.
These scars are a result of hip surgery that I've had both in 2017 and 2018. You would call them a hip arthroscopy. The bones in my hip joint kind of catch on one another, and yes, it is as painful as you think it sounds. So I've had to have surgery for the surgeons to cut back some bone and repair some of the damage in the hip joint. The type of surgery they did is minimally invasive, so they use two kind of incision points, and they use one of those for a camera that can look inside the joint, and the other one is for the actual surgical tools to do the job. But this type of surgery is so that you can heal faster and so that your scars are not as apparent as if you were to have a larger hip surgery, which is quite interesting. It's funny because before the surgery actually happened, I had a consultation with my consultant. At the time, I didn't really think about what he was saying because I wasn't really focusing on the scarring. I just wanted to feel better. Now that I think back, he never really mentioned anything about if my skin in particular would scar differently. Maybe he didn't know, but I didn't ask the question either. Maybe I should have been specific in saying, will my skin be different to maybe a light skinned person who gets the surgery? So I did the natural thing and I went to Google. So as you can see there, the type of examples that I saw online didn't really match up with what I have now. Obviously, the people that I saw and the people that you saw on those pictures of the hip arthroscopy scarring, they are most likely white or at least have very pale skin regardless of what their ethnicity is. And therefore, their scarring looks a lot different to mine. That's not to take away the impact that scarring can have. It doesn't matter if theirs looks like mine or theirs looks any different, that can still impact you and your mental health. But mine doesn't look anything like that. In fact, they're a lot more significant than those that you saw online.
So I've told you my life story, you're probably bored of me now, but that still doesn't answer the question. Why does dark skin scar differently than light skin? But I don't think I'm the correct person to be able to answer that question, so I found someone that can.
A lot of the research points to the fact that we know that dark skin has denser collagen fibers.
That's Dija Ayodele. She is an aesthetician and the founder of Westroom Aesthetics, which is a boutique skincare space that specializes in skin of color. She is also the founder of Black Skin Directory, an award-winning platform that connects people of color with skincare experts, professionals, and products.
I know lots of practitioners who are all different colors who I would confidently let them treat my skin. So I thought there is a disconnect here, and it's important for people to know of these other practitioners. So Black Skin Directory is literally a platform to highlight other practitioners, whether they be white, black, pink or blue, who can confidently treat darker skin tones. Collagen is what, it's a protein within our skin, it's what gives us the plump, you know, smooth skin that we have. And obviously as you get older, you lose collagen, and that's where wrinkles and lines start forming. So we know that we have denser collagen fibers. And when it comes to skin healing, collagen has to be remodeled and redeveloped. The idea is to smooth that, to return the skin to the state it was in, but skin doesn't return to that state. And the end state of any trauma is going to be the scar that forms. And on darker skin, the denser collagen fibers and the power of our collagen fibers to regenerate means it can over-regenerate. And in that over regeneration, it can then cause the race scarring, the keloid scarring. And so you have hypertrophic scarring, which tends to stay within the site of the injury. But then you have keloid scarring, which tends to go over and above that injury and can continue to grow. Even after you've reached a point where you consider it healed, it can continue to grow and become bigger and bigger and bigger, because that's just a malformation, a defect in the collagen regeneration process. It just continues to go. So there's a complete lack of research into keloid scarring on dark skin, which is why you also have a complete lack of imagery. You can find keloid imagery, but if you want to find specific keloid imagery, like say, for example, how you were looking for yourself relating to you, because I looked as well, there's nothing. It's all on white skin. So there's a complete lack of imagery of keloid scarring, and there's a lack of research into keloid scarring.
As you're probably already aware, I'm not the only person with dark skin that has scars. So I wanted to speak to someone else to see what their experience was.
Hi, my name's Jay, or you might know me as Fifth Star on my social media. I had two operations on my leg to remove benign tumours when I was 11 and 17. Then I had muscle biopsy when I was getting diagnosed with an autoimmune condition, which is a scar just here, and then I have a C-section scar, which is in my lower abdomen. I feel like there isn't that much information about how scars heal, and darker skin definitely does, you have more of a tendency to keloid, and that is something I've dealt with. But for me, my scars usually start off like normal thin lines, and then as they heal, they get thicker and raised. But then once they kind of start getting older, they lighten and they get flatter. So like my oldest scar is lighter than my actual skin tone and is flatter. Even for just normal skin conditions, whenever they speak about rashes, they always say like they're red, and like my rashes don't go red. I don't even ever go red. So yeah, I think there's a lot more that could be done in the medical community, and advocates like myself can do our part by sharing our stories. So that's it, I guess.
I actually wrote an article about this beforehand a few months back. It was published on Galdem, big up to Galdem. I did a bit of research and found an academic article written by two researchers in Canada, and they looked into four of the major textbooks used to educate med students in the US and looked at the images included in those textbooks. And they found that dark skin was heavily underrepresented in all of those textbooks, and that light skin was overrepresented. And this was not just for skin conditions, this was across the board. And obviously one can't make a definitive answer about the consequences of that, but you can suggest sometimes that this may contribute to the bias that you sometimes see in the medical industry. And it's important to make sure that even though it seems small and that it's just pictures, that all people are represented across the board, so that medical students and medical professionals alike can be educated about all skin types, the body in all of its forms and all of its shades.
I think generally it's definitely getting better. There's more awareness, but it can definitely be 10 times, 100 times better than it is now. The research obviously needs to happen, but the research is guided by, you know, money and how much money companies have and how much money companies want to, you know, invest. So what can we do? We can continue to share imagery, we can continue to ask the image, we can continue to be visible, we can continue to request of our medical professionals that they be fully trained in all skin tones and all skin colors and how things present, but also working with things like within counseling services, because if you have been left with a scar that you were not expecting and how that affects your self-esteem, you know, working within having that service provided as well. So I think it's a 360 degree approach, and we will obviously improve and get better and better. I mean, you've given me an idea of maybe having a page on the site that actually just like a scarring page. This is what scars look like. So we continue to do that. It's an upwards and uphill service. I wouldn't call it a battle, it's a service to provide.
Thanks so much for watching that video. I really hope you enjoyed it. And thank you so much to Dija Ayodele for appearing in my video. Please follow her and all the amazing work she does in making sure that people with dark skin or skin of color is being able to have the same opportunities to understanding their skin and getting treatment as other skin tones can do. So please follow her work there, and also follow the Black Skin Directory as well. Thank you to those who send videos in to appear in this video as well. And lastly, I say thank you a lot, don't I? Thank you so much to you for watching this video. video. If you liked the video on whichever platform you're watching this on, whether that is YouTube, Instagram, IGTV, or Facebook, make sure you like the video or put a heart or give it a thumbs up. Any of those. And make sure you share the video around so more people can see it, because that really helps me out a lot. And follow You Look Okay to Me on all of those social platforms. I'm not going to say thank you again, but I appreciate each and every one of you for watching this and watching the last video, the first flare. There'll be more content coming out soon. I guess this quarantine has given me inspiration for more content, so I appreciate you being here. I will see you in the next one.